We are racing here in round 15. Great launch from top position by the number 28 bike, Olmi Thangavaara. Sasaki slots himself into second place, ahead of Holgado. Around the outside of Holgado comes Tatsuki Suzuki on the layer part. He's in a little bit wide though. Oh, there's a bit of drama further back down the field.
Three or four riders down at the back of the field. Was watching Dennis Foggia off the line. He got passed into turn one by Giamma Masia. That's Josh Whatley, and I think that's Carraro at the back of the grid who's serving along that penalty. That's merely academic now.
So Guevara made the perfect launch from pole position already. Four or five bike lengths between him and the chasing pack through turn five for the very first time. A chasing pack led by Ayuma Sasaki. It's as you were in terms of the front row starters. Guevara first, Sasaki second, and Holgado third.
And Suzuki Rain maintains fourth. He's just taken that back from John McPhee, who of course started alongside him on that second row of the grid. Sergio Garcia has gained a couple of places on the opening lap. He's now up into the top 10. You'll see him at the back of the picture, but this will concern him, seeing Ethan Guevara already out front and already into his rhythm.
Yeah, Foggia was one of the big losers in that first sector. He started sixth, the Mazzano winner. He slipped back down to eighth by when he came through that opening sector. There's Masia out well wide through turn number 11.
Yeah, track limits will be monitored there, so you have to be careful. Lorenzo Fallon was also involved in that incident at the start. So Fallon, Carraro and Whatley involved. Carraro has rejoined and will have to come through the long-up penalty in addition to the incident he's had on the opening lap. You can see already this leading group is being strung out a bit. We expected a fast pace in this Grand Prix, and Ethan Guevara is living up to billing. He is trying to stretch this out already to the third sector. He's got a 0.4 of a second lead.
Yeah, making it very difficult here for Sasaki to pick up any kind of slipstream. He might have already broken the toe here. And Ohtola's had a great first lap there. Ryusei Yamanaka, already a crash fest on this opening lap here in Aragon. Ryusei Yamanaka's had a tough weekend. He started 21st place. The Japanese man's gone down at turn 13 and not the prep he wanted to go home to Japan in 5 days' time.
Such a long, long run here then through the double apex corner. It's turn 16 and 17, and a good run through there for Sasaki. He was able to pull a bit of time back on Ethan Guevara, so it's a 0.2 of a second lead, but the three front row starters have gapped themselves from Tatsuki Suzuki in these early stages. Garcia has been getting busy on this first lap. He came through the third sector in 10th. He's already moved past Giamma Masia and Xavi Artigas. He's just up behind Foggia in this second group.
Yeah, that top three are already 3/4 of a second clear of Suzuki in fourth place. We'll try and look at the back of the field here to find out what happened. The incident involving Fallon, Whatley and Carraro. They're just coming into our view now at the top of your picture in the heartbreaking zone for the first corner.
It looked like Carraro was on the inside. Fallon was on the outside, and it is so tight, as I mentioned, through that first corner. You can see contact further back between David Munoz and another rider who was alongside him. It just tightens up, so if one rider loses it on the inside, you've got absolutely nowhere to go. There you see the contact there between Carraro and Whatley, or Carraro and Fallon, should I say, and there you can see just nowhere to go on the outside.
Just don't know whether Fallon might have actually clipped the rear tyre of Whatley's teammate Scott Ogden there. Anyway, what was not in question was three riders were taken out of this Aragon Grand Prix on the very first lap. Back at the front then, sweeping down the hill towards turn 12. This is one of the favourite overtaking spots around this 5 km Aragon circuit. Sasaki and Holgado, though, not close enough, nowhere near close enough to pounce on Ethan Guevara. They drop down through turn 14 then on this lap number two. Through the second sector, Tatsuki Suzuki struggling to go with that top three. He's nearly now 0.9 of a second behind Holgado as they come onto this 968-metre long back straight.
And we've seen this a few times this year, but Dennis Foggia is getting beaten up a little bit. He's down to 11th place now. He's been passed by Sergio Garcia and Giamma Masia. David Munoz has now also gone past him. There is Yusei Yamanaka, who's remounted. He went down at turn 13, the corner he's approaching now. But early drama for Dennis Foggia. Here is what happened then to Yamanaka. You'll see him coming through the pit. This is turn 13. We'll see the Japanese rider tumbling out of contention.
Oh, that was a nasty one, wasn't it? Flicked him over the handlebars there. Normally you lose the front on the way in, but that was a fortunate one there for Yusei Yamanaka. So then we're about to complete lap number two. Well, we have completed lap number two. Guevara and Sasaki, the two men with the hot pace at the moment. In fact, there's nothing between the top three men. Guevara, Sasaki and Holgado all exchanged 57 nines. The slightly quicker of that top trio was Sasaki in second.